I think these are the shamans, yeah, right here. Alright. Split you guys up. We'll be using this a lot later, and especially once we start fighting, like, really dangerous enemies. Like, if we start bumping into, like, Death Knights and Cuisinarts and stuff, fighting those things in a group, on the off chance that it actually happens, is a death sentence. But we'll be splitting them up. Are you injured? Oh, you are! Well, you can just... Alright. Okay, so these, if I recall correctly, you can open? Yeah. So I'm sure that these things are all kinds of trapped. Anything that's actually in them. Alright. Open all of them here. Okay, nothing, one, and then nothing. Alright, so we've got three of them in here. Alright, Chunk. This is your one role in the party. Don't stuff it up. Good boy.
I don't know.
Staff, a ring, and a freaking healing potion. That's wonderful. Use a mod to give them mediocre pathfinding. Ha! Yeah, the basic pathfinding in this is not great. It is, like, really bad. Really, really bad. Not that I'm complaining, because I am also really, really bad.
I don't know.
Oh, it's the Goblin Watch code. We will want this. This is, I think we actually want to give that to the lady in town.
I don't know.
Okay, so Rove is going to be holding quest items.
Hmm.
Oh, yeah. I am going to just quickly print screen that and open up paint.net here. Yeah, go ahead and paste that in there for future reference. Alright. Now we are going to waddle back to town and see if we can turn this in for fun and profit.
Let's get out of here.
Also experience points. Yeah, I believe you are correct. There's like a combination lock in the place. And we will want that to be able to navigate it without killing ourselves. I think there are also some trees around here that you can, like, pick fruit off of.
Closed.
Seriously, you're an inn. My lord.
Hello, come on in.
Give me food and let me sleep. Those are your two roles in an RPG, inn. Do your damn job.
I need your help.
Goblin Watch. Thank you for taking care of that little detail for us. Here's your gold. Feel free to return to Goblin Watch anytime to finish clearing out the rest of the monsters. We can't pay you, but you can have anything you find. And we got XP, look at that. Levels for everybody. Your sleep changes how much gold you use. This is two right there. Holy crap, I never noticed that. That's a really cool touch. Thank you for letting me know about that.
How about some training?
That's neat.
Okay.
Okay. Where can I find trainers, miscellaneous skills, identify item? All right, the Buccaneer's Lair, which is actually right here.
Closed.
Open from 6 p.m. Oh my god. One day I'll remember what buttons we actually have to hit to play the game.
You're not one of us.
Okay. Buccaneer's Guild. Where is your membership?
Greetings and salutations.
Like, I appreciate what they're doing here with the membership to these guilds, but it is so frustrating.
Hello. Greetings and salutations.
Oh my lord. I don't even know. Let me, again, Might and Magic 6, Buccaneers, Guild membership. The high action gameplay. But, alright. Owner, da-da-da-da. Okay. Who are you guys? Okay, one of them has a home here. It doesn't, of course, tell me where. Oh, we'll find it. Yeah, that's true. Like, you gotta get your memberships once, and then you're done.
Salutations. Hello. Greetings.
Which, yes, is not enough.
Greetings.
Blade's End membership? Thank sure. You. I don't know what the Blade's End is, greetings, but we're members now, and there's Buccaneer's Guild. But yeah, Celt's right. If you're looking for competent play, you're gonna have a bad time here. There's going to be derping from start to finish.
Well, look who's here.
Okay, so who do I want identifying stuff? Our casters are probably going to be blowing most of their skill points realistically on spell stuff. But I think I might give it... I'm gonna give it to Swell, actually.
Without it.
You give him Merchant, too, but I'm not going to, because I don't care that much about money.
I don't know.
All right. Identify item. And look at that. Now we know what things are. Well, we know what some things are. What about level 3? There we go. Phantom Cloak. Good find.
I don't know.
And this ring is probably magical if you can't identify it. And then a bunch of other miscellany. Which we don't really care about. Lavender Trash. Good talk. You, I am giving Disarm Trap rank 3. And more ranks and bows. Body and Spirit. And Fire and Air. My goal is probably going... Well, I don't know if I want to focus more towards... Because water is our teleportation magic. Which is really probably all I'm going to be using water for. And at this point in the game, I don't know that, like, Town Portal and stuff would be super useful to us. Well, down the line... Oh, Merchant affects training costs. I didn't know that. Shit. That is good to know. Yeah, I am the same, Blue Eyes. Like, I... To me, if I start taking a game super seriously, it kind of sucks the fun out of it. But, like, I don't, like, hyper-optimize for the most part. Unless it's, like, optimization that takes, like, basically no effort, then I'll do it. But if it requires me to, like... be prescient about things. Gonna be a bad time. Oh, is this a secret by any chance? Because it looks like this is a secret, according to ye olde mini-map. We're back. Aww. Hi, guys. Ha ha! Death magic. I wanna check something on Chunk. No, I don't think so. I need to get an enemy that runs. I want to see if I can just chunk. If I can just left click. Arrow. Oh my god, get out of here. I'm trying to cheese game mechanics. Will he? Oh, he will. That is good to know. That means that I can get archery on the back row. And when it comes to fighting enemies at range, instead of mashing the E key for the auto attack like I have been doing, I can just left click. And that will actually help me conserve mana in the short term as well. For all those club-based attacks the back row is currently participating in. No, you don't. Chunk, you are just a Stone Cold killer, man! You're playing a Final Fantasy Tactic mod. Oh, I know exactly what mod you're talking about, Blue Eyes. Like, when it comes to, like, games that people cheese, like, people go hard on Final Fantasy Tactics. Not that it's particularly difficult to do, but, yeah, like, people have got, like, some crazy difficulty levels for that game.
Aha!
Some chainmail, a secondary suit, and a button that I'm sure is a trap of some sort. Now, pick up the gold. There we go. And some leather armor. Basic.
No.
Basic? Oh my god. Basic, thank you. I need to get proficiencies on the back row, at least for like armor and stuff. Eventually. I'm saving before I touch this. Okay, it didn't do anything. I was expecting possible Are you gonna death magic me when I... No. Oh. Oh, there's just one enemy. Terrifying! A common rat! Okay, so yeah, that's a door. That's a door. Armor that makes you smarter. Hey, man. Don't you judge. You gotta put on your thinking hat, right? Seriously, you guys? Come on. Okay, that's too many. I would like your biggest horde of orcs. No, that's too many. Also, our buffs are wearing off. Want to buy permanent until rest buffs. I do have to say that I think the earlier games handled buffing better, where they just all reset at, like, you know, 6 in the morning or whatever. You shit! Throwing death magic at me! Only I may throw the death magic. Oh my lord. Could you imagine being an exterminator in a fantasy setting? Like, wolves the size of small children. Large children, even. Like, terrifying. Alright, you need to die so that I can possibly nap. Of course not. Why would I be able to nap? Oh. Y'all know I want to open that, but Chunk's unconscious, and that would probably end very, very poorly for me.
Not here. Here.
Come on, game.
Not here. Not here.
I'm just gonna
not
mash
here.
The rest key until you let me sleep. That's how this is gonna work. You can try. It would be explosive, exactly. I mean, at least the group would go out with a bang. Counts for something. Alright. Saving the quick save from Grayface is so great. Oh.
I don't know. Aha.
Okay, so we have a crappy wand.
Aha.
Or a crappy mace, rather. Scroll of cold beam.
I don't know.
Scroll of something better than cold beam. Mana potion and a wand of something. This I'm interested in. I don't know if you can blind fire wands. You might be able to. Can we? I'll need a test subject. Mind blast. Alright. Good wand. We're gonna hold on to that. I like mind blast. We just did horrible things to that rat's brain pan, and now it doesn't do much anymore. Poor little thing. Oh god, makes it fun to mix potions. Like I said, I'm not really planning on doing much brewing in this, because the high tier potions are, they penalize you at the same time they boost your stats. And that just rustles my jimmies. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna use this wand, because I know if I don't use it now, I'm never gonna use it. I'm gonna save it for that boss fight that's never gonna happen. Alright. Exactly! Celt knows! I'm curious if I do... Okay, so if I hit E, he won't use it, but if I click to attack, he will. Okay, because I don't want him to use it on, like, rats and stuff. But, like, goblin shamans? Okay. Alright, so let me really quick pull up... Alright, so let's see. A is a trap, which is this one right here. And the others open a bunch of doors, and P is a reset, and an M is a maintenance. I immediately regret this decision. Oh no! You say maintenance, I don't expect teleportations into shit shows! Fucking... Oh no... Oh god, just circle strafe to victory! This is why we saved before we did that, by the way. Combination is 1, 2, 3, 4. Celt, you and I both know that you're a damn liar. Oh my god, there is no way. There is no way. There is... There's no way. Swell, you got this, bro. You got this. I knew it.
No eternity lies before thee. Thy work in the land of the living is not...
So this is the death screen.
Turn,
it was bound to show up sooner or later.
Certain we will meet again.
Salt and vinegar? Oh, man.
Okay.
Yeah, but thankfully, we have quick saves. Killing level 20, realize it's crap. Wait, exactly! Exactly! Like, that's the thing, is like, normally in games like this, I'd be like, oh, I'm gonna save that one for when we really need it. And, yeah, it'll never happen. But no, there's a bunch of doors in a row here, and we have to open the way through. But realistically, what is the path? I have no idea. So, we're just gonna hit everything that's not M, and see what happens. Because there's only one trap, and that's on A. Well, that doesn't look like freedom to me. Alright, and then this resets it. Alright, so let's see. D. That opens door one. Then F opens door two. Door three is L. We have one, two, and three open. Now we need to open four, which is B. Now we need to open five, which is O. Now we need to open six, which is D. And there we go. Super simple. Super simple. Thankfully. Oh man, wouldn't it be like a classic RPG thing to just like have you figure that out on your own? They don't give you the code for it, and they're like, nah, bro. Have fun spending 8 hours. You need to spell a certain word. Oh, do you spell goblin with it? I wasn't even paying attention. It was probably backwards. That was probably Neilbolg. See, this is why we gotta keep you around, Sel. You pay attention to the games. I'm just here to play them. Oh, so this is probably where Swell died right here. That is a lot of critters in there. Thankfully, they seem to be quite feeble. Oh my god, just die. You're a rat. You're not supposed to survive more than one attack. You're not supposed to have overpowered variants. You're fodder for first level characters. We're not even first level anymore. Didn't a kid disappear in here? I think we find them, if I recall correctly. I haven't really explained too much about the interface. Mate, just kill this thing and I will. There. Okay. So, these two slots on the right here, these are actually hireling slots, and you can hire townsfolk and they'll come with you and give you benefits. Like, there'll be one that'll just give you free item identification. The downside to them is that having them with you, they take a cut of all gold you find. Some of them are worth that. Like, there's one that we could get, I think, probably in this first town. Oh, if I hit E on Rove and he doesn't have mana, he starts blowing wand charges. That sucks. A banker and a trainer. I just remember there being one that you really, like, you came out ahead if you had him. You are probably right, if I had to guess. Critters, magic traps, and a lone kid. I mean, that's how RPGs work, man. These old games, they don't care. Especially Might and Magic. These games are just a glorified excuse to run around and killing things so that you can watch your numbers get bigger. Who plays these games for their stories? Oh. You found a poop chute. And you activate this. No. 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 I don't want to go down the hole. I'm gonna save. Anchors 20% gold, find 10% of all gold taken. Nice. And yeah, some dude, like, you can get some that'll, like, crank up your spellcasters, like, casting levels and stuff. I remember always using the one that identified items, and I think there's one that can cast town portal spells, and those were the two that I always ran with. But we'll see. Banker sounds like a win. Oh, that is a lot of critters. Damn it, Rove. I forgot to cast Wizard Eye. I should have known those things were there. I didn't. All told, I'm actually pretty pleased with how our progression has been going here. Plagues notwithstanding. Yeah. Well, because, yeah, with the town portal guy, like, you can just go and hit that plus 20 attribute thing and then just leave. Assuming you don't want to also hit, like, the developer studio. Otherwise, if you don't want to go that route, you just, like, walk out and let the dragons eat you. And you lose the, like, 1,000 gold pieces that you find in the place, and that's it. We're not using any cheese ball strats here. Admittedly, we're also not soloing the game with a fucking sorcerer either. Half the party is diseased, though, so that's, you know, fun. Yes, I think they're diseased. Yes, they are, in fact. One is green diseased and the other is yellow diseased. What's the difference? I have no idea. Oh, he's only tier 1 diseased. She's tier 2 diseased. Okay, and you can see that her stats are... Rove looks like Rove. He's trying to get back to his blue skin color. He's just got to turn yellow first. Secret where you can get actually... Yeah, the food dispenser. Yeah, oh no. Oh no. Oh, I want to actually really quickly check here. Do I still have a save? Okay, so what I want to do is actually, I want to load this quick save. And I want to do a hard save here. Just in case. Just in case, like, we're down here and we can't get out, so now I have a save before we fell down the hole. Okay, can we nap?
Rest here, let's get moving. We can't
Come
rest
on.
Here, let's get moving.
Come on.
Rest here, let's
Come
get
on.
Moving. Rest here, let's get
you.
Moving.
Less than ideal.
Got it.
Nice.
Oh no.
Aha.
Oh, there is sparks in this wonderful. We'll eventually be getting that on Rove and probably using it far more than it's worth using. Okay.
Got it.
Oh man, chunks. Oh, we got broken gear in the party. That's worrisome. I mean, it's just a shitty club, but here, Chunk, have a better one. Dagger upgrade for Rove, for when he eventually starts using a weapon again.
Got it.
Oh, and a bow!
Uh-huh.
A bow! Wonderful! There you go, I think that's actually probably better than a crossbow. 4d2. 5d2 it is, which means it is going... Chunk. Chunk gets first pick of bows, because he's a shooty boy. Another unidentified ring. Ah! Where the hell did you think? I probably spawned while I was looting. The bastards. Yeah, what now? Got proper arrows and death magic. it's true. I do, in fact, do diplomacy with a sword.
Got it.
Because, I mean, if they're all dead, none of them are opposing, right? And we got, like, two really good shields. Gold. I'm gonna have to start spending money on proficiencies for people. Like, I'll want to get Gold Leaf a shield. I'll probably get Chunk some armor skills. Damn it. All this money, I'm not gonna let it accrue infinite interest in the bank, sadly. Do pointy diplomacy. Damn it, it works. You can rest.
Can't rest now.
No,
it's too unsafe.
Of course not. Rove's out of mana. I worry about how many charges this wand has left.
Help!
I'm wasting it on rats. Okay, Rove's asleep now. We're good. The rest of the party can just do what the rest of the party does. Where's this going? Oh, look at that. We have discovered tentative freedom. It was totally a secret door. I don't mean to brag, but I totally called that. My decades of game playing experience have shown me that if the map shows a hole in the wall, there's probably a secret door there. And the back row is just really sad. What you guys get for eating at Denny's when Swell and Chunk were like, guys, don't get the steak at Denny's.
Hello,
at like...
Coming right up.
Enjoy 2 in the morning. I can speak from personal experience. You do not want to do that. How we get food poisoning, children.
Can we assist you?
Alright. Heal.
Be with you.
Y'all still... I gotta save. I can never remember. Oh, yeah, it is spacebar. Seriously, I want to bribe you guys. I have an average reputation and I even have fame. Being dicks. Now we need skills. No. Where'd you guys come from? Also, how are are we looking? All right, we're a ways away from leveling, so we're gonna go hit shops really quick. I need to dump an inventory here. Imagine not.
Don't touch the merchant.
That bad, huh? That. Hammers. All right, hammers and maces are different classes. Good to know.
I don't know.
Won't buy that.
I don't know. I don't know.
Oh my god. I'm just gonna sell it unidentified. I know it's worth less. Honestly, cannot be asked. It rustles my jimmies something fierce that, like, in a game like this, like, Swell is our identification guy and we have to pass him all the gear to identify it. It is so tedious. That can go, that can go, that can go, that can go.
Come again!
Have a look around.
You will probably buy my jewelry? You will.
I don't know.
Oh, he'll buy our scrolls too. Our crappy, crappy scrolls.
I don't know.
So are these things magic? That's the question. Are they magic, or is the game trolling me? I didn't even hit a button there, and people are shooting arrows. That worries me a little bit.
Looking for a weapon?
You identify... No. We gotta go to Iron Fist if we want to get this stuff identified, sadly. I honestly don't care that much. I'm trying to think if there's anything I actually want to do here while we're here. I guess we can check and see if there's any spells available with anything. Feeling of feeling exhausted, but you've already slept 9 hours and Jesus, man. Doing okay?
The magic,
you're like malnourished
fire,
or something?
Air, water, and earth.
What you got, bro? Protection from cold. Deadly swarm. Because sometimes you just gotta throw the bees out there. Poison sprays. Empty. How many shots does it shoot? I think poison spray shoots 5? Oh no, 1 shot on normal. Yeah, so that is just like, well, 1 per point, 1 to 2 per point in water magic, because he's using firebolt currently. Which, yeah, is just a flat 1 to 4, so it's not scaling at all. The shame you don't have sparks, friend. I would buy it if you had sparks. Mostly blame Neverwinter Nights. Oh. Yeah, that game gets chunky. I'm not a huge fan of the original campaign for Neverwinter Nights. Shadows of Undertide is really good, and Hordes of the Underdark is freaking great. But the base game is kinda rough. Hey, friendo. I'm just, you know, lessened, now running away like a freaking coward. By which I mean moving backwards so that I might better... No, waste my ammo on you. Alright, guys. Going in. Ah, we're going out. Dip in really quick, stab a dude, and then flee like a coward.
The spirit, mind, and
all right, the adventurer's way. There's no lucky day. Cure weakness. Meditation. Precision would be nice. Tempting. That affects the entire party at mass. I'm gonna buy that. I don't know how much I'm going to use it at the moment.
Yes.
But down the line, that'll be pretty useful, I think. Exactly. It can't hurt. I just have to remember to cast it. We'll just give it to basically the front row. That will, between that and Bless, because I think Bless is a damage buff. Oh no, bonus to hit. Alright, so Bless gives you a bonus to hit, but Precision gives you a bonus to accuracy. Okay. I see what you're doing. So you got +13 to hit. Not bad. It's a good number. Better than zero, I suppose. Exactly. Exactly, Byakko. Exactly. Again, with the random arrows, that really worries me. Because at some point that's going to happen in town. Bless is much better. Well, yeah, I agree. Because Bless, like, flat modifies the stat, whereas accuracy is, like, it modifies your to hit secondarily type thing. I get ya. But yes, I agree. Neverwinter Nights is, like, woo! Neverwinter Nights is a good game. I really like it a lot. A lot of people crap on it, but I really like it. Oh, you jerks. Come around so that I can kill- oh no. That was a mistake. Nope, 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 nope. Alright. Oh, we are- yeah. Man, freaking Hour of Power. You got Hour of Power, like, Day of Protection. Those are, like, the big two that you usually lean on. But I think one or both of those is tied behind light or dark magic in this. Aggro everything. This is just mean. A lot of really nasty critters in here. Okay, so it's goblins on the left and rats on the right. The rats are much more manageable. What I want to do is this. Loop around. Right, flee! Flee in terror! While your masters get mind blasted. That wand is saving our ass. Oh, it's pretty great. No, you don't. Oh, no, you don't. God damn it. Jesus. Accidentally. Because, like, you hit a number key to swap to a character at the bottom, but if you hit it twice, like, if you hit it while the character is selected, it opens their inventory or stat screen or whatever. And when you're in combat, what character you're activated to swaps quite often. Troublesome, so if you ever see me accidentally, like, opening inventories and whatnot, that's what's doing it. Of course Mail cheesed it. Like, that is how he plays these games. It is not my style of playing dungeon crawlers, but it works for him. Oh my, that's more trouble. God, that thing has got some hit points on it. Crap. Oh no, there's another one. This wand, I swear, is earning its weight in gold. Wells down. Alright, let's pull back. See if we can have a nap. Alright. That broccoli wand is doing work, though. I am not even mad. What's his hit point total that 5 points of healing is topping him up that much? Oh, so good.
Aha.
Who would have thought actually using consumables as you found them would make the game easier? This heresy. A bunch of energy potions, which are next to useless. Mana potions are good, though. Okay. Careful progression. Ow. I need fireball. I need to be able to start fireballing my party. That's when this game's gonna get good and I'm gonna start using words that are probably best left in the dictionary.
I need assistance!
Oh, shut up, Swell, you're fine. Quit being a baby. You just need to hit the enemies and these fights would go a lot better. Although I'm sure that being, you know, just sodden in plague isn't helping at all. Oh, I need power cure. I need power cure so bad. Actually, what I need to do is get body magic, or what is this, spirit? No, this is body. Body magic on Swell so that he can do some healing as well. Although he doesn't exactly have, like, a mana pool to speak of, I guess. You guys. Seriously? Seriously? There we go. Okay. And you can't unhear it, but the goblins are saying my dress. We're gonna go back, and we're gonna hit that temple. Because this plague is racking just too much here. Also, it gives me a chance to drink. Military scout group, bag-handed with healing magic items worth about 3,000 gold. Nice! I know, fight with Jesus Christ. Selt, based on the horror stories I've heard about your group, I don't know why you even play with them anymore. They sound like they do not give a shit about the effort you're putting into your game. Screw it. I'll heal the back row, too. There you go, guys. The middle row. The midden row. I don't know. Video games. Poor guys run around nearly naked. I don't know, maybe that's just their... I don't know. Maybe that's what their culture deems appropriate. Maybe wearing a dress is like... I don't know. Maybe you're saying that you, like, want to marry somebody if you wear a dress. Can't... Yeah, there you go. Dress kink. Bam. Problem solved. Alright, we're back. We're buffed. And Rove has spell points. And I'm accidentally opening inventories. I can kind of understand that, Cell. I can kind of understand that, where you're just like, what new shit are they gonna pull this out? That is so many goblins, and not a level to be had. I really want to know how many charges this thing has left. I'm getting paranoid.
I don't know.
No, we've aggroed them. Ah. Get that out. God, now they're like janking on the corner where they can attack me, but I can't hit them. Oh, there's another passage there. I didn't even see that. What do we have? We're learning goblin psychology. It's goblin psych 101 here. Either it has charges or not. There you go. Schrodinger's wand. I figure it had like 50 to start. I don't know. Wands in this might just start capped when you find them. Jeez. Already we need a better healing spell. This is just not... First aid with its 5 points of healing is just not cutting it. We have potions, but... Eh. What's up, guys? You may die at any time, please. Thank you. Oh my god, dude. Jeez. So disappointed in you. Get him! Get him! Ah! Man, even Swell's laughing. Paladin-like of him. Alright, more goblins. And they're just gonna funnel right in here, too. It's okay. I'll wait. Using consumables does make things easier. Like... These fights with, like, the goblin kings and stuff would be much more difficult if I didn't have this wand. Because it's, like, the hardest hitting person in my party right now hits for, like, maybe 10 damage, I think. 6 to 12, and this wand is, like, regularly doing, like, 15 to 20. Things doing work. It's just... the numbers are running out and I'm getting afraid. I could use my healing potions, yeah. But I don't... like, I think they only heal for, like, what, 10? Yeah. 10 points of damage isn't much, and I've got one.
I don't...
oh, I need more potions.
I don't know.
I also need to identify all these rings of dubious magical quality. Whoa, hey. Whoa, hey. It feels like I should be dodging the fireballs when they throw them at me. I'm not bothered that I'm not, because, like, we're a party as opposed to a single character, like, in Doom or whatever. But, oh, I think we're out of wand. Are we? We're out of wand. Dang it.
That was two.
Apparently, Rove has shared the power of vegetables with our enemies for the last time. So this right here, a situation like this is where turn-based combat is really good, because you saw I was backing up and shooting these guys, and they just dodged all my arrows. If we're in turn-based mode like this, they can't do that, because they're stationary. So you can shoot them, and then just drop out, and then just go back, and then just drop out, and then go back. So we're not going to do that. We could, we're not going to. I'm either going to do a fight in turn-based or real-time. But that's a thing we could do. Put the blood in the bottles, you got red potions. Man, if only it were that easy. That is a nasty group right there. There's like two shamans and a king with them, I think. Oh, let's see. Bless. Nope. My god, what are you doing, camera? Bless. Now we wait. We'll just click away, because I don't want to blow spells at this range. Oh my god, we'll blow spells at this range. Fuck it! Oh, wow, I actually killed a goblin shaman there. Unexpected. Take down some of the trash mobs here. Stop throwing death magic at me, you jerks! Dad. Alright, we'll wait. We'll let them come to us. By which I mean I'm going to peek my nose out and waste spell points on them at every given opportunity. The auto-target is not targeting what I... it's just not targeting what I want it to target, sadly. Call it real-time with pause, oh my god. This was the game that did it first, Celt. We have found the progenitor of real-time with pause combat. Well, no, I think it probably goes back further than that. Wasn't Draken? Didn't that game have... like, I know that game had real-time combat, and it was AI, but I think you could pause that too, couldn't you? It's been so long since I've played that air quotes game that I can't... come on, guys. Come on, guys. Yeah! Nice. Look at that. We took that fight, and we didn't even need the power of vegetables. Can I have a nap now? Hell yeah. We did good in stabbing, and then we get our nap time. Adventures. Everyone understood how the fighting system worked in Draken? It was just... as far as I could ever tell, having played it, like, semi-recently, it just always felt completely arbitrary to me. Like, you just cross your fingers and toes and hope that your guys survive. Draken is not a good game. It is a game, and it is unique. And it actually did some pretty cool things for the time that it came out. Like the overworld exploration was pretty unique. But then you had to actually play the game and it was less entertaining. Out of here, get out of here, get out of here. Yeah, I know we're out of food. Thankfully the way back is clear, so if we need to flee, we can and it won't be too much issue. Loot the body. There we go. Where you going, buddy? You just want a hug. Oh no! You've betrayed me! That's too many hugs! Oh no! That is a lot of incoming hugs right there.
Got another.
mean, they're dying to stray firebolts, so these things aren't, like, particularly beefy, but there are a lot of them. I begin to worry that maybe we are the food. Okay. Alright. This is where we stand, and this is where they die. Look at that. Not a single point of damage was taken this day. All of our mana, however, was expended. I don't think... Oh, we found a ring on one of them. I was gonna say, like, just because you can loot enemies and they don't drop anything, or they don't give you money, doesn't mean that they're not giving you anything. Because they can drop items. You... My god. Get some meat from the monster you kill and use it as food. I mean... You could do that in, like, WoW. You know, you go out and you kill critters to collect their meat bits to create fancy sandwiches to give you stat boosts. But I get what you're saying. I mean, you did that in, like, Dungeon Master. The Dungeon Master games, you'd kill, like, the giant worms and you get their rounds and that's how you fed your party. Not exactly common stone soup. Yeah, roguelikes, a lot of roguelikes do that.
Not enough.
Okay, that room was not nearly as bad as it looked. It was busy, but manageable. Come on, guys. Kill the thing. Get it! Oh my lord! Front row! Quit fail! Oh my... Alright. That's... Oh! Hello. I remember you guys. This is where we died last time. I don't know why. All right, I was gonna quick save and I hit space to jump, but X is jump, and I'm glad I didn't die there.
No.
Two-handed swords.
No.
Two-handed swords. I remember being kind of bad in this, and a wizard hat. That. This is just vendor trash. It doesn't do anything for you. Unless it's a quest item or something, which it might be.
I don't.
This is gonna be an upgrade for Chunk, though, if I had to guess. And that is a bit of gold. Not a bad find. I don't know why the camera is. There it goes. Being weird. Yeah, Elder Scrolls, yeah. True, you can eat critter bits. Or use them to make potions, as the case may be. Very true. Okay. Part of me wants to go back to town. The other part of me is like, press onward and see how far into this thing you can get without getting killed without spellcasters. I would assume that maybe this is the last of it right here. Because I think the maintenance dropped us into this area right here. Friggin' Lysandus. These things' whole shtick, it seems, is that they are like super fragile, but they attack really, really fast. For what that's, you know, doing for them. Another pack of goblins up here. Do not see a king among them. And only one shaman. Oh, you guys are a bad day. Pride precedes many a fall. But at the same time... Ah! Boss man's running. A boss man's dead. Whoa, hey! Alright, yeah, the slopes in this game, if you hit a slope just right, you can see it kind of, like, catapults you. And if you're not careful, you can kill yourself doing that. Take it easy, Biako. Have a good one. Hey, Rainer. Welcome. Hope you're doing well today. Glad to have you on board. Come on, guys. I really need to get bow skill for the back row. Holy crap. Get him. Get him. I really just need to get weapon skills for the rest of the party, I think. Okay. I need to be careful about rounding these corners, because I assume that there are going to be more goblins down here. Alright, I see a king in there. Yeah. Hi, guys. With your fiery death and I think maybe a chest down there. I can't tell if that's a chest or more enemies in the background. Guys, if you could hit, it would just be wonderful. Good job, Chunk. I appreciate you. Have a blessed spell. So that you can maybe do that more often. Oh, God. Nope. Back row is just, at this point, completely useless. They can't really do much of anything. I guess Goldleaf can maybe smack somebody with her mace. That is about it. Rove. Not so much. Get him. Mob him down. Come on. Okay, no, we're running. He's still at half health. That foe is beyond any of us. Actually, now that I think about it, how do we get out of here? Oh, wait, no, I'm an idiot. Never mind. I was gonna say, how do we get out of here? We fell down that hole, but no, then we found the secret way out. Aw, oh, man, these games are still, well, I guess I can't say super popular, but amongst retro gamers, like, it's hard to do much better than, like, the old Might and Magic games. Good stuff here. Aw, oh, man. If they get that many players, though, we'll get, like, another Might and Magic 10, and that ended just in sadness.
Enjoy your stay. Hello, come on in. Coming right up.
Alright, so we have food. Any levels? Levels? No. Getting there, though.
I don't know.
This. I'm gonna identify this crossbow.
Looking for a weapon? Come again.
I don't even know what it is, but I paid for it. An accurate crossbow. Crossbow, Jesus. So I think it's less damage than his bow. 5d2, 42 plus. No, never mind. It's better. Go, and we will trade down, and now we have an extra for the eventuality.
I don't know.
Oh man, 9 was so bad. I remember seeing it on store shelves and wanting it really bad, and my parents were like, no. And I'm thankful that I missed that one. And 10 is... it's Ubisoft Might and Magic. I don't much care for what Ubisoft has done with Might and Magic. Like, in any way. Heroes of Might and Magic 5 was okay. But I'm not a fan of, like, their lore and stuff. It's not nearly as interesting. It feels very, very generic compared to, like, what we had with this and 7 and 8. Finish Might and Magic 6 and moving on to 7. 7 is probably my favorite of the gridless games. 7 is about where I would stop playing, personally. I'm not a huge fan of 8 because you can't create your party. The less said about 9, the better. And 10 is just makes me sad. I don't know if I would say 7 is the best in the series. My heart lies with World of Xeen. I like the old grid-based ones. But I think 7 is the best of, like, 7, 8, and 9, that trilogy. We have rats. I was hoping for a chest, but rats are okay too, I guess. Roving experience points to be had. More flyers. Which I'm not particularly bothered by because they died a stray spellfire. Okay, with the merge mod. Something like that I would probably be more likely to do, yeah. I was looking at that where you can play through 6, 7, and 8, like, all in one go, and, like, that would be interesting. I don't know if I would have the patience or the time commitment to do it all back-to-back. But yeah, like, that was the big thing that kept me from playing 8, well, from enjoying 8, was the having to, like, find party members and stuff. I know some people really like being able to have dragons in your party and all that stuff, but I don't know. I like making my own characters, it makes me feel more attached to them. Oh, that's actually kind of cool then. Yeah, I would probably enjoy the game much more in that way. Just run through the entire thing with my own party.
I don't know.
What is this? A ring. Oh, now it's mine. Back there. Some gold. Studded leather of precision, +4 accuracy. Very nice. That's a good find. Can rove. Use that. Or not rove. No, chunk. You cannot. Damn it. I really gotta get the rest of the party some proficiencies with things. I need to stop being such a cheap ass. Progression needs a lot of work. Oh, that's worrisome. Where is he? I know there was another one. Uh-huh. No escape for you, my delicious little experience point bundles. That's like Fallout New Vegas, or not, Fallout New Vegas. Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas, where they have the merge mod for those. A friend of mine ran through those, and it looked really interesting. Exactly, Cell. They haven't earned armor yet. When Rove can solo a Mega Dragon, I'll pay for his armor proficiency. Until then, he's on his own. Look at him! Common rats are beating Rove up. Wait, that one's a giant rat. It doesn't count, though. Best way to play Merge is the continent hop. Like, go from one game to another. I mean, I don't think that's necessarily bad, but if you're trying to, like, play through one game's storyline, like, all in one go, I could see that being pretty annoying. Speaking of 200%, I think this game, if you hit F2? Yeah, it doubles the move speed, which seems like a good way for me to get killed by hordes of rampaging monsters. Oh, there are always more rats.
He's healing.
Come on, you guys. Come on, it's the last pack.
Help!
Don't fail on me now. Bless yourself. I do have healing potions, but eh. Moving backwards and shooting seems to be working. Oh, where are you going, buddy? Easy. Rove, of course, in the background. Swimming in disease. Last rat. Probably. Maybe. Hopefully. Anybody else? I think there's supposed to be a kid in here somewhere. Out here playing with the plague beasts. And coward is saving like a madman. Playing from 6 to 8. Had to use some console commands to make it so it felt fresh. Ah, it's kind of rough. I mean, it's understandable. Like, I imagine it would be incredibly difficult to balance something of that scope, because you're, like, trying to make three games that are wildly different play nice together. Like, that's insane in and of itself. So, like, I can fault some, like, balance issues here and there. Where you going, rat? I thought we were friends. Oh, God. There we go. Chunk inflicting one damage. Sadly, apparently in this one, archers lost the ability to shoot at point-blank range. Okay. Man, I sure hope we don't find a child in this box. We didn't. Okay.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Then we found a magic crown, possibly. Or a serpent spear. Okay, but seriously. There's a kid in here, right? Sherry is in the Shadow Guild hideout. Okay, so now we're probably just in the wrong dungeon then. Okay, so I think with that, we might be done here. You ready to level? The rest of the party will level one of these days. Maybe. Shooting at point blank. Yeah, but like that was the archer's whole shtick though in these games, was that they were supposed to shoot in melee without like incurring penalties. But apparently now they're not that cool anymore. They can't go like full Legolas on enemies.